Hey guys, Taps here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm super excited to share another video with you today. This video today would be for folks who have a backup of their website files and they want to upload it to a new hosting account, or perhaps you bought maybe a website on a flipping website, maybe on Flippa or whatever. If by any means you have your website files and you want to turn it into a live website, then this video is for you. I'll show you exactly how you can upload your website file to the best budget hosting out there, and which of course is Hostinger. If you already have an Hostinger account, that's fine, then we can continue. But before I do that, I want to just take a moment for those who do not have Hostinger. In case you don't have, you can just check the description below to check a link for you to get up to 80% off through my affiliate link. So once you click on my affiliate link below, you'll be brought to this website here where you have the opportunity to buy for as low as 2.99 per month. So you can click this claim deal button, it will bring you down here, and from here you can just add this to cart. You're almost there, complete your order, and that will bring you down here. You can see all the packages we have. This is a per month, 12 months, 24 months, and the 48 month is there already. If you come down here, you can see that you have something you can buy for as low as $143. But if you come to click this coupon code here and you use my coupon code, which is DAPS, and apply, you will see that you will get a further slash down of this price now to 129.7. So almost $130 for a 48 month plan. That's a 4-year plan, and that's amazing. You can also check the other months here. We have 24 months, we have 12 months, and you can also get your free domain for the first year with all this package. And if you come up here, you'll be able to see that you can have up to 100 website, unlimited traffic, unlimited SSL, weekly backups, 100 gigabyte SSD storage, and fantastic deals here. I believe you can use this opportunity to check out, and once you do that, you will be able to access Hostinger. This is my Hostinger account. I can just you can see my premium web hosting here. I can just manage this hosting, and I have this website here. So let me add a new website, since I'm trying to migrate a new website here. So that brings me here for me to create and migrate a website. So we have two options here, so we'll be using the migrate option. So we can either choose to upload or transfer our website, but in this case we want to upload our file. So I will click here to go to the backup, the zip file of my backup. So here's a zip file of my backup file, so I will upload that, and once I do that, I'll just hit the import button. This may take a while depending on how fast, how heavy your files are. Please note that the maximum file size you can upload is just 258 MB thereabouts. As far as I'm uploading, this may take a while. We just have to give it that time for it to fully upload. Okay, yeah, our files have uploaded successfully. So it's bringing us to the next step here, which is for us to name our website. It's for us to buy a domain name or use an existing domain name. Since this is a website we had before, I want to use an existing domain name. So now I'll put the name of the domain, which is 34sndpictures.com. So I'll hit the continue button. This is where we need to update the name servers of our domain. It's very important for us to now point our domain to Hostinger, since we already have, and this is the domain, this is the name servers here that we need to point our domain to, since we want to now host our website with Hostinger. But for me, I've been able to point my domain, so you can go to your preferred domain registrar. For me, it is dynadot.com. So you can see this is my download account here, and you can see this is the domain here. As you can see, the domain is already pointing the DNS setting to the said name servers. So for you can update your name servers. That's something very easy to do. Then hit the continue button. If you have a problem doing that, I believe you can contact your support. They should be able to help you do that. So you can see you're collaborating with a partner, so they're trying to set up your account, and this may take a while too as well. So you need to give this time. SSL is being installed automatically, and some other things are happening in the background for you to set up your website. So give this some time, a few minutes, and this should be done. Yeah, well done, you're ready, as you can see here already, so there's no need to go away. We'll not be viewing our website right now. We are not connecting a domain, so let's go to control panel to do some things. We just need to check to see that everything is fine before we continue. Okay, so this is now the dashboard for this website 34 SND Pictures. First things, you need to come down, come to security, come to SSL. You need to check the status to be sure that your SSL is active, so you can see this is active yet, and that's fantastic. Sometimes it's not active, there may be error, you may need to come and check. So you can come to your files and come to file manager, and then let's access 34 SND pictures. So you can see the public HTML. So you open this and you want to make sure that you can see I have a folder for 34 SND pictures here, and also then my WordPress files. Make sure that your WordPress files are not in this folder. If they are, you need to export them. In this case, when I uploaded these files were in this folder. I had to extract them out. So you can see this folder is empty. What I needed to do was just to highlight all the files and then I move them back to public HTML. So for example, if I click this right now, if I come here, you see you can see move files. So once you click that, you can then move it back to public .html files, because these files need to be in the public HTML for it to be visible to serve your website. So after that is done, I think that is good enough. Now let's check our website and let's see what we have. So you can see that our website cannot find a database because we've not uploaded our database. So what we have only done was to upload our website files. So what we have to do right now is to upload backup database files. Okay, so right now we will need to go back to Hostinger. Okay, let's find our files. Yes, this is our files here. So let's come to where we have our WordPress files. So first off, we're looking for our wp-config.php. So that's the file. Let's open this file. So we can scroll down here for us to see our database details, which is the database name, username, and you can see that we have details of the old hosting and also the host name linking to our old server. So in that way, there is no way wp-config is able to interact with the hosting we had previously. So we have to create a new database. So let's come back here. Let's scroll down to database and let's come to management. This is where I can just create a new database. I can just give my MySQL database name here and also the public HTML, which is destination, which is fine, and also put a password and then create. Since I have an existing database down here that I'm not using, I rather want to use this one, assign into my website. So I'll click the assign button, as you can see there, and then I can put the name of the website, which is 34 SND pictures, and then assign this database to this website. That is all that is to it. So once we do that, so I can copy this now and then come back to my wp-config file and then upload that here, change the database name. So copy this quietly in between the two asterisk, make sure you don't make any mistake, and then paste the new one. Make sure that there is an asterisk before and after, just as the way it is. You can come back here to copy our user, and then we come back here, we copy this user here and replace it. Super simple, super easy. So now I can copy this password here and maintain the same password. So once this password is copied, I can hit the save button to save wp-config file to interact with the new database. And then when I hit this three asterisk here, I can change my password here, paste my new password, and then update this. So that way the same password here must align with the one we have in our wp-config file. So we can close that. So the next thing for us is to access our MySQL database. So once we are at phpMyAdmin, you can scroll down here to see all our data table, all our tables, click check all, then drop all the tables. So this is us trying to empty everything we have. So, and that has been successful. We've been able to delete everything we have here. So we come here, we click the import button, we choose a file that we want to upload, and then we have to come to our file where we have our database. So for me, this is my SQL file, this is my backup database. So I'll open that. Once I have that file here, I'll scroll down and then I'll hit the go button, and our database is uploaded. Depending on how large your database files are, this will finish in less than a minute most times. So, okay, as you can see here, our database has been uploaded successfully, and then we are good to go. So let's come back to our website. Let's refresh this. Look, I still have the same thing here. I might need to perhaps check this website in an incognito mode. So I'll copy the website, I'll open an incognito browser, and then let's see. Oh, we still have the same thing, so I might have to close this. We still have a problem with our database. So let me come back to our files. Let me check our WP config file. Okay, I see where the mistake is here. So you can see our database hostname here is pointing to the hostname I used in my previous server. So I'll change this to localhost. Localhost is what most web hosting use for. Unfortunately, the previous one is using something entirely different. So I'll change this to localhost, and then let's refresh my website. Bingo, you can see my website is loading fine. Fantastic. So my website is back. So this is a photography website design here, and you can see everything is loading super beautiful. So this is exactly how to upload your website files into a live website. I believe this is super simple, super easy. If you find this video very useful, give me a thumbs up. If you have any issue whatsoever, you can let me know in the comment section. That's my time. Thank you so much for watching this video. I would see you in another video. Bye for now.